So hello all, this is Sandeep Mandal from DES Engineering, and today I am uploading a video on Venturi flow analysis. So in this analysis I am designing an intake manifold of Duke RC 300 engine. So in Venturi module I am just iterating, you can refer this video and iterate it again and again by following all the procedure. In this video what I'll be calculating is mass flow rate, pressure variation and velocity variation. So let's begin with the video.
For analysis, what I'm going to do is I'm importing a Venturi model in ANSYS Fluent and creating a fluid flow environment with that. So let's begin with ANSYS. I'm just opening a space claim module by double clicking on this. Soon it will be opening. Now after importing a model here, you have to import a model first here by going this folder, and this is the step file which I need. So drag it here and close this. We have to do certain pre-processing settings for that, and we have to repair a model. For make sure you upload a step file in here. If you import a IGS file, then it will take a surface consideration and there will be no volume extraction. So here you will see the edge formation, and we don't want this edge formation, so we have to go for repair and extra edges. We have to remove extra edges so that our volume should be uniformly created. So 8 areas are formed here. So go for clicking in this direction and you'll see the lines are removed automatically. Go for prepare, volume extract, and edge selection volume method. So select this module and again this module, click on OK. So in this way you have to create a volume extraction, and after doing that you have to suppress it for physics so that we don't consider this model in our further calculation. If you are doing a heat transfer analysis, then it is very beneficial to create don't suppress this model for physics, because we have to see a heat conduction through that model. So but in this simple analysis we need this only. I have already created this. So you can, you have to do here, I am doing a Venturi iterative analysis. So by referring this tutorial you can modify your geometry as per you are getting a result. If you are getting result in better way, not getting in a better way at pressure outlet something, Mach number or mass flow rate, just change this model geometry and reapply the process which I am doing here and satisfy your result. Close this guy. I'm not saving it, but you can save that. So going for this, right click on import this, browse, and this is, I have previously saved this model, so it is generated. Now it is going, then I'm going for meshing module. In the meshing module what I'm going to do is creating a meshing, tetrahedral meshing with named selection such as inlet, outlet and wall symmetry condition. So in the meshing module our geometry is successfully uploaded. This is the inlet section and other one is outlet section, and outer surface is wall symmetry. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a tetrahedral mesh by selecting this whole geometry, tetrahedrals. Now I'm giving it a value of 1 mm mesh. You can also go for finer mesh, but actually I have to go for this coarse mesh, because for the tutorial purpose I'm not going to use effective meshing criteria. But you can go for even 0.5 also. So just let me say it as 3 mm mesh. Make sure if you're doing analysis go for finer mesh, but for saving my computational time and conserving that portion I have used a coarser mesh. So it seems like it's fine. Now go for face selection tool, select this face, type N, say inlet, make sure you spell correctly. Now this is the outlet section, select this face and type N. Now this upper surface hole are wall symmetry region, type N. So this is the wall symmetry. You have created three name selection, inlet, outlet and wall symmetry. After doing meshing and name selection, close this guy and again we are pre-processing the result in ANSYS Fluent. It seems that meshing in the meshing module the geometry is not successfully uploaded, so go for right click on that and update that mesh. After updating this, you have to start a setup for ANSYS Fluent. In this ANSYS Fluent, if you having a computer with more than two processors, you have to do a different setting with double precision method, which I am going to tell you in further video, sorry, in this further example. So it's taking time. So it is successfully uploaded, you see that right tick mark, go for setup. And now double precision, if you have a parallel processing unit with your computer, go for parallel and type your number of processor in your computer, but I am going for the serial. Now the meshing module is successfully imported in ANSYS Fluent. So here blue region is showing inlet region and red region is outlet region. So this is the Venturi contour. Let's discuss the general parameter, general meshing consideration. We are using a pressure based solver with velocity formulation of absolute condition and time is steady. We are not interested in mid result, so we are going for steady state analysis. In the steady state analysis, we focus on only outlet portion, outlet result, outlet mass flow rate, outlet velocity only. You can also consider a gravity here, but if you don't want to consider it, then neglect it. So because gravity consideration is very low affection in the intake manifold design, so I'm not considering it, but you can do a iterative method with that only, that also. So go for physics. Don't on this energy equation. This energy equation is only for thermal type of thermal and any Navier-Stokes equation containing temperature range. Then you have to analyze, tick mark this. Go for viscous module. Now in this viscous module, K epsilon is very best. So click on OK. ANSYS Fluent generally default material is air only. So let's check that first. So fluid is air. We don't have to change anything here. After that, go for boundary condition. We are applying a inlet velocity to this portion. Inlet velocity, edit this. Velocity inlet at inlet section. We are setting it as 20 meter per second. Depending on your type of value, you can vary this this input values. Now why this gauge pressure is zero? Because absolute pressure is 1 atm at standard temperature pressure condition. Now go for outlet. It is a pressure outlet and here you will see the gauge pressure is automatically set to zero. Why? Because absolute pressure is 1. That's why gauge pressure is zero. Those are all relating quantities. Now, after setting up pre-processing parameters, go for solution and hybrid initialization. Sorry, you have to first compute it from inlet and then go for initialization again. 10 iterative points are created with this value. This can do with manual calculation also, but there is no need to do a manual calculation with this software. So definition, I want a mass flow rate at outlet with plotting condition, report file and report plots. Click on OK. Now go for result and create a plane. plane, I'm going to create at yx plane, so point to normal and give a z vector to a one value. So that plane should be created in xy plane compulsorily. Create. Now go for contour, new. For contour 1, select a pressure with plane 4, contour line, banded condition, and save and display. So this is the pressure variation plane. Again go for new contour. Now this time you have to see a velocity magnitude at plane 4 with contour lines, banded condition, and save and display. So this is the velocity variation you will be observing. Now it's time for creating a solution animation. So go for create animation, solution animation, and drag it upward. This contour 1, and use active, and okay. Now again go for this solution animation, contour 2, use active. Okay, so there are two animation has to be create here. First one is pressure variation, and then second one is velocity variation. Then after this, go for run calculation settings. Initialization has been done, report definition also created. Run it for 200 iteration, maybe 500 iteration, but after 200 iteration the solution is start converging at a particular level, so that the value of mass flow rate is constant at outlet. Hit calculate. So the calculation is completed, and our this iterative residuals are shown. So why this is so bulgy and variations are there? Because I have used a coarse mesh. You can also use if you use fine mesh, you will see a straight line in at this 180 to 200 iterative region, because I have run this analysis previously also, so I know that. This is the mass flow rate I'm getting. So at the end, I'm getting it as 0.0372, in between these two values. So if you use a finer mesh, this is a straight line at this region. So make sure you mesh with a fine quality. So this is the pressure variation, and this is the velocity variation. You can also get animation for this. For animation 1 and play 1. So these are the pressure variation at 20 meter per second velocity. So you'll see the ranges are changing again and again with the velocity variation, how it is interacting, how the fluid is interacting with the wall and changing a pressure, because there is a turbulence with this geometry. There is absolute turbulence creation. Also the pressure is getting lower and lower up till it is getting to a negative value. Like closing this guy, go for animation, and again go for velocity variation. So this is the velocity variation I am getting. Why it is so rough? Because of the fine mesh, because of the coarse mesh. You have to mesh it up to 0.5 mm mesh. Up to 0.5 mm element should be created to see a better understanding of mesh variation and velocity variation here. But for the demonstration purpose, I am saving my computational time. So close this guy, and you are getting a velocity. After that, close this whole thing. I'm going to show you the CFD post results. Double click on this. So the results are uploaded in this region. This is the wall symmetry, and if I'm okay that, so we want to see a planar region. So go for location, plane, and create one XY plane and XY region, apply. So this is the plane which I got here, and I want to color it with pressure first, this is the pressure variation and this is the graph. So go for this default legends, appearance, fixed value, and set it to 2. Now it is totally considerable. Okay, so this these are the pressure contours. You'll see that the pressure is 2577.10 pascals here, and at this region it is 7641. So pressure at the inlet is high because area. So here I am having three windows. By selecting it here, if you press 1, there is one window, and again click and press 3, you are having this 4 window. So on this, let me plot. Again, I have to go for 2 windows. So here, again create one plane. And I'm going to see a velocity variation, color with variable, and this should be velocity V, and apply. And you'll see the velocity at this section. For default legend view, you have to go for variable fixed and select it for 2. Now, so these are the velocity variations. Velocity increment, maximum velocity is reached in this case is 160 meter per second when I am applying a 20 meter per second velocity. This result is furthermore evaluated with the finer mesh. Make sure, I am saying it again and again, you have to do it for finer mesh. So go for volume rendering. Okay, apply. So these are the volume rendering which you see here. Volume rendering for velocity. These are the volume renders for velocity. So in this way you have to do analysis by iterative method. You have to select or modify a geometry and do this analysis again and again until you got your answer for. You got your requirement at the end condition, end user condition. So in this way you have to design a intake manifold Venturi for Duke engine. And thanks for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe. Also, if you are having any doubt for result consideration or calculating any type of result, please mention in comment section. Thank you.